Violence has raised questions about how best to deal with rioting and disorder on our streets. And I'm now from we've just spoken to Patrick Mercer. I'm now joined by Darkest Howe, who is a writer and broadcaster. And you can speak to him now. And Marcus Dow is in Croydon. Marcus Dow, are you shocked by what you've seen there last night?
No, not at all. I have been living in London for 50 years. There are so many different moods and moments. But what I was certain about, listening to my grandson and my son, is that something very, very serious was going to take place in this country. Our political leaders had no idea. The police had no idea. But if you looked at young blacks and young whites with a discerning eye, and a careful hearing, they have been telling us, and we would not listen, that what is happening in this country to them.
Mr. Howe, if I can stop you, Mr. Howe, for a moment. You say you're not shocked. Does this mean that you condone what happened in your community last night?
I condone, of course not. What am I going to condone it for? What I'm concerned about more than anything else, there is a young man called Mark Duggan. He has parents, he has brothers, he has sisters, and few yards away from him, where he lives, a police officer blew his head off.
Well, Mr. Howe, we have to...
Let me finish.
Mr. Howe, we have to wait for the official inquiry before we can say things like that. We don't know what happened to Mr. Duggan. We are going to wait for the police report on it. If I can take you on a little bit, you were talking about your grandson, you were talking about young people. You were talking about your grandson, you were talking about...
They have been stopping and searching young blacks for no reason at all. I have a grandson, he's an angel, and he began to think he was coming of age when the police slapped him up against the wall and searched him, and he thought he had now had a gold star. I asked him the other day, apropos of a sense that something was going seriously wrong in this country, I said, how many times have the police searched you? He said, Papa, I can't count. There's so many times.
Mr. Howe, that may well have happened, and if you say it did, I am not to gainsay you, but that is not an excuse to go out rioting and cause the sort of damage that we have been seeing over the last few days.
Where were you in 1981 in Brixton? I don't call it rioting, I call it an insurrection of the masses of the people. It is happening in Syria, it is happening in Clapham, it's happening in Liverpool, it's happening in Port of Spain, Trinidad, and that is the nature of the historical moment.
Mr. Howe, Mr. Howe, if I can just ask you, you are not a stranger to riots yourself, I understand, are you? You have taken part in them yourself.
I have never taken part in a single riot. I've been on demonstrations that ended up in a conflict. And have some respect for an old West Indian Negro and stop accusing me of being a rioter. Because you want to tell me to get abusive. You just sound idiotic.
Darkest Howe.
Grandchildren.
Thank you very much for joining us from Croydon. Darkest Howe, their writer and broadcaster.
Any projects or initiatives that give you hope? Hope in terms of moving towards where you think that improving their lives or got a chance to improve. a quick follow-up question. I mean, in terms of that, when we look, say, internationally, do you see any help there in terms of examples of where people move through?
Give me some clues of where you think we might see some examples.
Well, I mean, I suppose for me, even though it's not gone perfectly, in terms of the apartheid struggle, about what was achieved, and in terms of the forces that were advocated, something happened there, and so on. So it's not that it's terrible at all, but there's been progress made.
Thank you. suggest, just a suggestion, that universities are full of students. I don't know when I was at uni, we had to use SSPI. We got loads of students because when we was at uni, we had to find people in which that we could do questionnaires. You know, it might be a good idea for organisations like yourselves and others who are doing those very grassroots community engagement work to link with students who are doing their first or second years in certificates and research so that they can actually begin to put that in, put the necessary keywords in that could be recording the impact of the work that they do, but link those first and second years, because then you're more than likely don't have to pay for them. Number two, no disrespect to students, but I'm just keeping it real, because that platform was free when I was at uni, do you know what I mean? So there are opportunities to make those possible links. It's just a suggestion. I don't know if any students would like me for that, but I'm sorry. And the great political movements are the students. You know, look at where we are right now. Like, listen, move you out into the community and stick you in the civic suite. That place will be packed out. But trust me, I don't know if Damon is still the mayor today, but he would be most concerned to hear what's coming out of your mouth. Many of them, lots of those black community engagement, community workers. But look where you are. And these are students. Students are the ones who drive this agenda. Because there's no right for it.
Do you know what I mean? Let's hope so. Okay. Anyone else?
Yeah. Hopefully I was too much to speak up. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Those the same skills we can use when we get to home to learn to get institutions to drop their weapons that they use against us?
mean, with the first report that came out in 1993, I mean, it's 40 years on, as you said, no one in the police force has ever been lost their job because of racism, although it's been proven.
No one anywhere has lost their job. That's why no one anywhere pays a terrorist consultant. Anyone else?